Good evening, students. So tomorrow we have the topic mainly strategies for enhancement in food production, mainly plant breeding, and one more chapter we have microbes in human welfare. Two simple topics we have. So we will start the discussion of these two topics now. Aims of plant breeding is to grow. See, what are the aims of plant breeding? Plant breeding, you know, purposeful manipulation of plant species in order to create a new desired type of plants that are suitable for cultivation. So what are the aim of plant breeding here? Disease free variety. So the plants which we produce should be disease resistant. That first aim should be fulfilled. Then, as the demand of food is increasing day by day, population of the world is increasing, and we need the plant food in the form of fruits, vegetables, cereals, pulses. So we have to develop a high yielding variety to fulfill the food demand. Then we need to produce at least 4 crops in a year. 3 months, one crop means 4 crops we can produce. That means it should be early maturing variety. Early maturing variety. So when we have these characters, then we are able to fulfill what you call a green revolution. Green revolution. Disease resistant, high yielding, early maturing, okay, and getting adjusted to different climatic conditions, agroclimatic conditions. Then resistant to drought, salinity, various characters you would like to incorporate what you call in the crop plant. So we will go with all of these here. Next one now. Following are the steps of plant breeding. Fill up the blanks and choose appropriate option for A and B. See, plant breeding has mainly 5 steps, you know, important 5 steps. First, collection of variability. Then second one, evaluation and selection of parent. Third one, cross hybridization among the selected parent. And fourth one, you have mainly selection and testing of superior recombinant. And fifth step is testing, release and commercialization of new cultivars. So these are the 5 steps of what you call plant breeding. So first step, collection of germplasm, okay, collection of genetic variability. Second step, that is evaluation and selection of parents. Third, cross hybridization among the selected parent. And fourth, selection and testing of the superior recombinant. Last, testing, release, commercialization of new cultivar. So here, this fourth one is the correct option here. Which of the following is considered as a root of any breeding program? See, first step is the collection of variability. The plant part which you choose for cultivation, usually seed we use. In some cases, we use what you call vegetative propagule we use. So when you choose the plant part, you know, that is germplasm, what we have, germplasm collection, the entire collection of plant or seed with all diverse alleles of all the genes, okay, in a crop, that we call it a germplasm collection. So any plant breeding program, when you choose the parental plant or germplasm, it should have genes, you know, which can control different traits. Characters, okay, so it should have diverse alleles so that they can control different contrasting characters, different desirable characters. So that's why there should be genetic variability. The germplasm should have the genetic variability. So presence of genetic variability is very important, because the parental plant which you choose should have desirable character which are controlled by the genes, specific genes. So genetic variability is the root of any plant breeding program. Hybrid vigor, heterosis, same. terms. Okay, this heterosis term was used by Schell, right? So hybrid vigor or heterosis means increase in vigor or strength, increase in vigor or strength, okay, increase in yield of a hybrid progeny of a hybrid plant, of a hybrid progeny over its parental variety, that we call it as what you call this hybrid vigor or heterosis. Which of the following is the main aim of evaluation of germplasm in plant breeding program? See, when you choose the germplasm, that plant breeding material, whether it has a desirable combination of genes or not, which can control different characters or not, we have to screen that. Screening of germplasm is very important for desirable character. So, first combination of character. Suppose if the parental plant which you have chosen, if it do not have the desirable character, the entire plant breeding program will be waste. That's why before we do cross pollination between the two parental plant, we need to what you call check what kind of desirable characters are present in that. So 4-1. Next, now according to NCRT text, which of the following are selection and testing of superior recombination in plant breeding? This is 4-step. Okay, selection and testing of superior recombinant. So what are the different steps which we carry out in this 4th step? That we will see here, which steps are correct as per the selection and testing of superior recombinants. See here. It involves selection of plants among the progeny of the hybrid with the desired combination of character. See, in the 3rd step, what you have done, you have cross-pollinated 2 parental plants with a desirable character. You have produced a hybrid plant. So this hybrid plant, okay, this hybrid progeny, whether it has desirable characters or not, that we have to check. This is first character is okay. The hybrid are superior to both the parents with that. This is called hybrid vigor. Just previous question, I told the definition of the hybrid vigor. So it has both the combination of character which were not seen in the individual parent. Say it is high yielding character, okay, and one parent is a disease resistant character. So both the desirable combination of character is there in the hybrid progeny over the parental variety. This is also fine. Then this hybrid progeny which you have got in the F1 generation, first generation after crossing, this plant should be self-pollinated for several generations. Usually we self-pollinate for 6 to 8 generations so that we can develop homozygous plants. Pure line character, genetic purity should be induced. Okay, this is also what you call correct. They are self-pollinated for several generations. It should reach a state of uniformity or homozygosity. Suppose if homozygosity is reached, when you cultivate these homozygous plant, then there will not be segregation of character in the future generation. You have learned Mendel's law of segregation. Okay, suppose if these are heterozygous, the parental plant you have chosen for cross pollination is heterozygous, then there will be segregation of characters after few generation. Then desirable character will not be there in the parental plant, right? So this is also okay. So we'll go with 4. And next, now, Green Revolution depended mainly on plant breeding technique for high yielding and disease resistant varieties of. See, Green Revolution, the rapid rise in agricultural production. The rapid rise in agriculture production during 1960 to 1980, due to better agricultural management. Due to better agricultural management, okay, and that is better irrigation, use of fertilizers and pesticides, right? So better agriculture management and development of high yielding disease resistant usually semi-dwarf varieties of wheat, maize and rice. So we'll go with the fourth option. All the three agriculture production was increased. Method of breeding for acquiring disease resistance are, see, the plant should have disease resistant. So which method we follow here? Conventional method. In conventional method, disease resistant plant is cross pollinated with susceptible plant to get a hybrid. This hybrid plant has received the genes from disease resistant plant, so it will become disease resistant. That is conventional breeding. Then mutation breeding. Mutation, you are exposing the plant part to mutagen. Okay, improvement of crop plant through induced mutation is known as mutation breeding. Physical mutagen, chemical mutagens you can use, and you can bring the desirable changes. You can bring desirable changes. Okay, father of this mutation breeding in India, you know, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay, so desirable changes are brought through the induced mutation. So these two methods we can use for developing what you call disease resistance. Next, in 1960 to 2000, wheat production increased from dash tons to dash tons, while rice production was from dash tons to dash tons. So here A to D refers to. So from 11 million tons it was, and it reached to 75. Then rice production, it was initially 35 in 1960. By the time that is 2000, we reached up to 89.5 million tons. So we will go with what you call the first option. That is how we achieved green revolution. Semi-dwarf wheat was developed at, see, semi-dwarf wheat variety. Mainly, it was reported from Japan. American plant breeders, they used this semi-dwarfing gene. It is a semi-dwarfing gene. They used, and one semi-dwarf wheat variety they developed. One semi-dwarf wheat variety they developed. Now, at Mexico, okay, where Norman E. Borlaug was working, the father of green revolution in the world. So they used this. Norman E. Borlaug was working at International Center for Wheat and Maize Improvement. International Center for Wheat and Maize Improvement. So they produced three semi-dwarfing wheat variety. Sonara 63, Sonara 64, Lerma Rosso 64. So they developed high-yielding, disease-resistant wheat variety at International Center for Wheat and Maize Improvement, present in Mexico. So we'll go with the second option. Saccharum barberry was grown in what you call North India. It had what you call a poor sugar content and yield. Saccharum officinarum was grown in South India, had thicker stem and high sugar content. So here A to D refers to first option. See, this Saccharum officinarum was not growing well in North Indian conditions. That is why at SBI Coimbatore Sugarcane Breeding Institute, Coimbatore, what they did, this Saccharum barberry was crossed with Saccharum officinarum and they produced new sugarcane variety. This new sugarcane variety, thick stem, okay, long internode, that is high sugar content. High sugar content, thick stem, long internode, high sugar content, and it can grow well even in North Indian conditions. So that is how the sugar cane production was increased in India. Improved rice variety IR8 has been introduced in India from mainly Philippines. A semi-dwarfing gene DGOUGEN. This is a semi-dwarfing gene, DGOUGEN. It was reported from Taiwan. Okay. So using this semi-dwarfing gene at Philippines International Rice Research Institute, they have developed this IR8. Remember this. Then one more rice variety, that was the Taichung Native 1 was developed. Select the false statement. Hybrid maize, jowar and bajra have been successfully developed in India. IT Deccan Ganga, jowar variety CSH series, then bajra, that is Sajji, PHB, BJ, then BK. These are all some varieties developed in India. They are resistant to disease, they are resistant to water stress, high yielding. This is correct. Saccharum barberry was originally grown in North India but had poor sugar content and yield. Correct. Agriculture accounts for approximately 33% of India's GDP, gross domestic product. Gross domestic product, GDP. Okay, and employs 62% of population. This is also correct. So false statement they are asking. None of these. No statement is wrong here. All the statements are correct. Classical plant breeding involves crossing hybridization of pure lines, homozygous plant, right? Artificial selection to produce plant with desirable characters of high yield, right? It should be nutritionally rich in nutrient, then resistant to disease, right? So all the four stages it can involve. Traditional, classical means traditional plant breeding. When the breeder want to incorporate desired characters into the crop plants, they should say plant breeder or farmer, what kind of character they want to incorporate in what you call the crop plants. Increased yield, right. Increased tolerance to salinity, right. Resistance to pathogens like virus, fungi and bacteria, disease causing microbe, right. Increased tolerance to insect pests. So all these characters you would like to incorporate, plant breeder incorporate in desired plant. So we'll go with fourth option, that is all of these. Next one now, see ya. Wheat, we have Himagiri. Wheat, you may get disease resistant crop, which is resistant to leaf and stripe rust and hill bunt, cauliflower, Pusa shubra. It is also Pusa snowball K1. Okay. It is resistant to black rot and curl blight black rot. Cowpea, Alsandi antar Kannada dalu, Alsandi. Cowpea, that is Pusa common. Okay, it is resistant to bacterial blight. Bacterial blight. Then chili, that is Pusa sadabahar. So chili is resistant to chili mosaic virus and leaf curl. So resistant crop variety to particular varieties, these okay diseases. So here we'll go with what I call first option here. Okay, next, now you have to fill the blank here. The development of several high-yielding variety of dash and dash in the mid-1960s as a result of various plant breeding techniques led to dramatic increase in food production in our country. This phase is often referred to as, see, this A is wheat and B is rice, and IR8 and Taichung native one, I told. Entire collection of diverse alleles of all genes in a given crop is called as germplasm collection. So here, see, this should be second option. The new sugarcane variety had qualities like high yield, thick stem, high sugar content, ability to grow in North India. So choose the correct option. So we will go with fourth option here. Okay, match the following columns. Okay, the pathogen, the microbe which cause the different diseases, fungi. So which are the fungal disease? See, fungal disease, brown rust of wheat. Okay, it is caused by Puccinia, Gram nystritica. Then fungus can cause red rot of sugarcane. Is caused by Colletotrichum falcatum. It is also fungal disease. This is fungi, this is fungi. Okay. Late blight of potato. Late blight of potato is caused by fungus. By name, Phytophthora infestans. Phytophthora infestans. So, 1, 2, 3 are fungal disease. This one. Okay. Now, bacteria. 4, black rot of crucifer caused by this bacteria. Black rot of crucifer. Black rot of crucifer is caused by bacteria. Mainly, it is Xanthomonas campestris. Xanthomonas, this black rot of crucifer. Then blight of rice, it is also bacterial disease, bacterial blight disease. Okay, blight of rice is caused by Xanthomonas oryzae. This is bacterial disease. Then citrus canker, it is also a bacterial disease. Citrus canker. Okay, very common disease in citrus, Xanthomonas citri. Xanthomonas citri, that is going to cause citrus canker. So 4, 5, 6, they're all bacterial disease. Virus, tobacco mosaic disease caused by tobacco mosaic virus, and turnip, both these are viral disease. It is caused by turnip mosaic virus. Right, so 7, 8. So we'll go with second option. Varieties by hybridization and selection, and shown below. Fill up the blank A to D. A, wheat variety. Variety is Imigiri, leaf and stripe rust and hill bunt. Brassica, Pusa Swaranim, current rye, it is white rust disease, resistant to disease, white rust. Cauliflower, Pusa Shubhra, Pusa Snowball, K1, black rot and curl blight, black rot, correctly matched. Cowpea, is what you call, it is resistant to bacterial blight. Then D, that should be chili, resistant to Pusa Sadabahar. Okay, the variety is Pusa Sadabahar and resistant to chili mosaic virus, tobacco mosaic virus and leaf curl. Next, plants can be made disease resistant through. So how can you make the disease resistance here? What we will do? Susceptible plant is crossed with wild variety, wild relative, which is having genes, you know, which can provide resistance to the most common diseases which are found in that particular region. So we will go with breeding of crop, no, with wild relatives. The most common commercial cultivating variety which is susceptible to disease is crossed with its wild relative, which has superior genes which can give resistance against that specific pathogen, virus, bacteria or fungus, whatever it is. Identify the correct pair of combinations. So which are the correct pair of combination you have to see here? Parbhani Kranti, resistance of virus Bindi. Okay, it is correctly matched. Parbhani Kranti, it is resistant to what you call yellow mosaic virus. Yellow mosaic virus, a Bindi variety, Abelmoschus esculentus, is crossed with Abelmoschus many hotland, Abelmoschus esculentus, a Bindi variety is crossed with a wild variety Abelmoschus many hotland, and they produced a new Bindi. This Bindi is resistant to yellow mosaic virus. It was named as Parbhani Kranti. Correct match. Then Pusa Gauru, resistance to aphid, mustard, rapeseed mustard. Okay, resistance to insect aphid. This is also correctly matched. Pusa Sadabahar, it is chili variety. Okay, Pusa Sadabahar is a chili variety, resistant to chili mosaic virus. Okay, and tobacco mosaic virus and leaf curl. So this is not correctly matched. Pusa Shubhra or Pusa Snowball K1, it is a cauliflower variety, resistance to fruit borer. Disease is wrong here. Cauliflower black rot and curl blight black rot, you know, black rot and curl blight black rot. Right, 1 and 2 are correctly matched. So here we will go with third option. Parbhani Kranti, variety of Bindi lady's finger, is resistant to, just now I told, yellow mosaic virus. Okay, IARI is situated at, Indian Agriculture Research Institute is situated at New Delhi, remember. Sugarcane Breeding Institute, Coimbatore, remember. Largest Indian Botanical Garden, Howrah, okay, Kolkata. National Botanical Research Institute, NBRI, at Lucknow. The ability of host plant to prevent the pathogen, from causing disease, which is determined by genetic constitution of the host plant, is resistance property, which can prevent the pathogen from causing disease. So because of presence of superior gene, genetic constitution, it has a natural property of resistant against particular pathogen. Okay, now Maitha Karam. They have given variety, okay, of a crop. So Brassica. So Brassica, you have Pusa Swarnim. It is also known as variety, mustard variety. Then cauliflower, Pusa Shubhra. Pusa Shubhra. It is also called as Pusa Snowball K1. Chili, that is Pusa Sadabahar. Okra, okra nothing but bindi, lady's finger, Pusa Savani, and one more is there, Pusa A4. Okay, so it is third option. Resistance to jessets in cotton and cereal leaf beetles in wheat is due to which of the following biochemical characteristic? It is due to hairy leaves. Solid stem in wheat is not attacked by stem sawfly. Okay. Smooth-leaved nectarless cotton variety is not attacked by bollworms. So these are natural properties which are present in the plant, provide resistance to insect pest. Biofortified rice are enriched in which of the following nutrient? Rice has been 5 times enriched with iron, so that this iron deficiency, what we have, anemia, can be overcome. Particularly the people who are eating the rice, common staple food for them. So it has been enriched with iron. May the column one with the two, bhindi. You have Pusa Epor. Cowpea, you have Pusa Snowball. Then rapeseed mustard, you have Pusa Gaurav. And cauliflower, you have Pusa Snowball K1. Right? So here answer is fourth option. Hairy leaves in cotton provides. Hairy leaves in cotton provide resistance to jessets, and hairy leaves in wheat provide resistance to cereal leaf beetle. Wheat, cereal leaf beetle, and cotton, resistance to jessets. So third option. Read the following statement. About 840 million people in the world suffer from hidden hunger. Wrong. 3 billion people suffer from hidden hunger because they are lacking the food which is a deficit in nutrient, like micronutrient, protein, and vitamin deficiency. Second statement is right. First statement is wrong. 840 million people are not getting adequate food to meet their daily requirement. To meet their daily requirement. Now, third, about 25% population suffering from hunger and malnutrition. Correct. Single cell protein, SCP, is one of the alternate source of protein for animal and human nutrition. Correct. So here, select the correct statements. So which are those? 2, 3, 4. So we'll go with fourth option. Next. IARI, which has produced a different nutrient-rich fruits, vitamin A-rich pumpkin, vitamin C-rich bitter gourd, Kerala, iron and calcium-rich, that is spinach, palak, protein-rich lablab, okay, Dolichos lablab, that is bean, garden pea, French bean, whatever it is. So here we'll go with third option. If the people suffer from malnutrition, if they don't have adequate food to eat in their day-to-day life, the diet which is lacking essential nutrients, okay, essential nutrients like iron, then iodine, zinc, proteins, okay, with specific amino acid, vitamins, okay. Then the people suffer from hidden hunger here. So what is the effect of hidden hunger on the human beings, reduced lifespan, reduced mental ability, increased risk of disease. So all of these is right. Which of the following pair is incorrectly matched in respect to the crop variety? Pusa Sawani resistant to fruit borer. Correct. Pusa Sawani, Pusa A4. Pusa Sawani, Pusa A4. It is a bindi variety. Shoot and fruit borer. Right. Pusa Semto 3. It is flat bean variety. It is flat bean, Jessids, Aphid, and shoot borer. And fruit borer it is. Okay, this is also correct. Pusa Gaurav, it is a mustard variety, resistant to aphid. Right. Pusa Semto. Pusa Semto is resistant to fruit borer, not shoot borer. So here fourth is incorrect here. Atlas 66 is high protein content variety of wheat. It is used as a donor for commercial production of other wheat variety. In mung bean, resistance to yellow mosaic virus and powdery mildew were induced by mainly mutation breeding. From mutation breeding, in mung bean, resistance to yellow mosaic virus and powdery mildew were induced. Himigiri variety of wheat, which was developed by hybridization and selection, is mainly resistant to leaf and stripe rust and also hill bunt. Biofortified maize hybrids are improved for amino acid content. It is lysine and tryptophan. Twice the amount of the amino acids are present in maize. Such maize varieties were developed. Match the column 1 with the column 2. Himagiri variety is resistant to hill bunt, wheat. Then Pusa Sorinim or Karan Rai is resistant to white rust in mustard. Pusa Shubhra is resistant to black rot. It is a cauliflower variety. Pusa Sadabahar is chili variety. It is resistant to leaf curl. It is chili variety resistant to leaf curl. So what can be the answer here? First option. Breeding crops for improved nutritional quality is referred as biofortification. Protein content and quality, oil content and quality, vitamin content, then micronutrient and mineral content. So we would like to improve these nutrients of the food in the crop plant, mainly through biofortification, biomagnification, that is the toxic pesticides, all that will accumulate at the producer level in the food chain, causing serious health hazard, environmental pollution. Bioremediation means from industry and from other sources, these by using certain genetically modified bacteria, we can break down these toxic impurities and converted them into non-toxic form. That is called as bioremediation. Which one of the following pair is incorrectly matched in respect to crop variety for disease resistance? Cowpea bacterial blight they have given. So what they are asking? Incorrect they are asking. So it is correctly matched. Brassica resistant to white rust, right? Wheat resistant to leaf and stripe rust, correct? Cauliflower, tobacco mosaic virus and leaf curl. This is wrong match. Cauliflower, Pusa, Shubhr Pusa Snowball K1. It is resistant to black rot and curl blight black rot. Now the column 1 with the column 2, protein content and quality. We have developed a high protein rich wheat variety. That wheat variety is Atlas 66. Vitamin content, particularly vitamin A, pro-vitamin A in carrot. Micronutrient content in case of this spinach, calcium and iron rich. Calcium and iron rich. Vitamin A rich carrot. Amino acid content. Okay, that is in maize, lysine and tryptophan amount has been increased. So it is the first option. Okay, they have given different variety name. How many crops are disease resistant and pest resistant respectively? We have to say Himagiri wheat variety. It is a disease resistant. Karan Rai is master variety. It is also disease resistant. Pusa Gaurav. It is a master variety. It is resistant to insects. Resistant to insect. Pusa Sem 2. It is a flat bean variety. It is resistant to insect pests. Then Pusa Snowball K1 cauliflower. Okay, Pusa Snowball K1, it is resistant to disease. Right? Then Pusa Epor, Pusa Savani, Pusa Epor, bindi variety, resistance to insects. Okay, like shoot and fruit borer. Pusa Komal. Pusa Komal is cowpea variety. It is resistant to disease. This is a disease. Okay, this is a disease. Insect disease. 1, 2, 3, 4 disease. And insect 3. So it is second option. In wheat, solid stem leads to resistance from stem, saw, fly. Okay, hairy leaves in cotton to jessets, hairy leaves, okay, in wheat, resistant to cereal leaf beetle. Then stem borer, high aspartic acid, low sugar and nitrogen content in maize provide resistance to stem borer. High aspartic acid, low sugar and nitrogen content provide resistance to stem borer in maize. Which variety is resistant to curl blight black rot disease? It is nothing but Pusa Shubhr or Pusa Snowball K1. It is cauliflower. Which is not protein enriched crop developed at IARI, protein enriched. So spinach is a calcium and iron rich, mineral nutrient rich. Flat French bean, garden pea, broad bean, okay, lublub bean, they're all rich in protein. Beans, Fabaceae family members. Pusa Snowball K1, resistant to black rot. Pusa A4, resistant to shoot borer. Okay, so it is third option. Which method have led to the development of several high yielding varieties of millets which are resistant to water stress? So mainly hybridization, hybrid breeding is yours. Pusa Swarnim is a variety of Brassica resistant to white rust. Species of Saccharum originally grown in North India was Saccharum barberi, Saccharum officinaris, South Indian variety. Which of the following can be used for cultivation of SCP like spirulina? Straw, raw materials, okay? Straw, sewage, wastewater from potato processing industry. All these are used. So, protein-rich microbial biomass, that is single cell protein. You can use the spirulina. You can use the chlorella. Okay. You can use the scenedesmus. Right. You can use the bacteria. You will come to know which is that Methylophilus, Methylotropus bacteria. Okay. So different types. Spirulina is the blue-green alga. So these are cultured on the nutrient medium that should contain these all raw materials. Find the incorrect statement. 250 gram of Methylophilus Methylotropus produce 25 into 10 to the power of 3 kg of protein. So what we say, 25 tons, okay, correct. The shift from meat to grain diet create more demand for cereals, wrong. It should be grain to meat, it should be. Then it is correct. The shift from grain to meat diet create more demand for cereal. They are given wrongly here, meat to grain they are given. 250 kg cow produce 200 gram of protein in its milk per day, correct. Spirulina when growing on sewage also reduce environmental pollution besides producing large quantity of protein, correct. So here, second option is wrong here, incorrect. Which of the following is source of single cell protein? Particularly the bacteria, 25 tons, 250 grams of this bacteria, Methylophilus, Methylotropus. Bacillus thuringiensis, BT, it is used as bio-insecticide, Azospirillum, loose association with the roots involved in nitrogen fixation, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, yeast, used in fermentation, alcoholic fermentation, bakery, all that. Micropropagation technique used for the commercial scale production. Micropropagation technique of producing thousands of plants through tissue culture. Technique of producing thousands of plants through tissue culture is known as what you call micropropagation. Banana, sugarcane, potato, all these can be what you call cultivated. Inherent capacity of a cell to regenerate whole organism, that is totipotency. TH Morgan used this word. Okay, a single plant cell when you culture on the nutrient medium, okay, it can give rise to entire new plant later on. This property is called as totipotency. Tissue culture is based on this totipotency. Ontogeny, study of developmental history. Study of developmental history. Phylogeny, study of evolutionary history. Study of evolutionary history. Proliferation means multiplying. Next, meristem culture is practiced in horticulture to get mainly virus-free plant. Okay, shoot apical meristem. Shoot apical meristem, which is having buds, axillary bud, all that. These meristematic cells divide very at high rate. They divide very rapidly than the virus multiplication in the shoot apical meristem. Virus cannot survive here. That's why if you use this shoot apical meristem as an explant to culture on the nutrient medium, you are going to get disease-free plant, that is virus-free plant. Haploid plants, haploid plant, you know, whenever you culture pollen grain, okay, you are going to produce haploid plants. Guha and Maheshwari, Sipra Guha and Satish Maheshwari, they have produced androgenic haploid plants in Dathura, in Oxia, useful in plant breeding program. Soma clonal variation, the variations which are produced due to spontaneous mutations. Spontaneous mutations through tissue culture. The plants raised through tissue culture, they are called as soma clonal variation. Soma clonal variation can be disease resistant, okay, saline resistant, drought tolerant. So such character plant can be produced. Pollen grains of plant plant is 2n is equal to 28 diploid number. Our culture to get pollen grain, you know, pollen grain is haploid. So haploid should be n is equal to 14. So when you culture the pollen grain on the nutrient medium, you will get callus. So what is the chromosome number in this callus? It should be haploid because the explant which you have used, the pollen grain, it is a haploid. So it should be 14. The technique of obtaining large number of plants through tissue culture is micropropagation. Okay, when use organized structure like stem, leaf, okay, root, anther, ovule, this we call it as organ culture. Plantlet culture, that is a tissue culture where you will get the callus. From the callus you will get a small plantlet like this. Somatic hybridization is carried out by protoplast fusion, say potato, tomato, okay, these protoplast you will get by dissolving cell wall, right? Then you are going to fuse this protoplast fusion, somatic hybridization, named this as pomato. Hybrid of potato and tomato is called pomato. The enzymes required to obtain wall free or naked protoplast. So you know, cell wall is made up of cellulose and pectin. Cellulose and pectin. So we need to use cellulase and another one, pectinase. So we'll go with second option here. Large holes in Swiss cheese are due to production of large amount of carbon dioxide by bacteria. You know, that is Propionibacterium sharmani. Fermentation is carried out, carbon dioxide is released. Lactobacillus mediated change of milk to curd occurs due to, that is, coagulation and partial digestion of milk protein. So here LAB are involved. Lactobacillus lactis. Lactobacillus acidophilus. Streptococcus lactis. These are all LABs which are involved in conversion of lactose sugar into lactic acid, and the milk protein casein is partially digested, okay, coagulated and partially digested, that result in formation of curd. Lactic acid bacteria convert milk into curd and improves its nutritional quality by enhancing vitamin B12 and prevents the growth of what you call disease causing microbes in stomach. Next, penicillin was extensively used to treat American soldiers wounded in Second World War. In Second World War, you know about penicillin, it is an antibiotic. Okay, this antibiotic was extracted from Penicillium notatum. First, Alexander Fleming. Right? So, it became a boon mainly to save the lives of the wounded American soldiers in the Second World War, the full potential of this penicillin antibiotic was established by Howard Lore and Ernest Chain. Ernest Chain, Lore, and Fleming, they got Nobel Prize for this. Antibiotics are drugs commonly used to cure bacterial disease. Semidwarf wheat, which was instrumental in increasing wheat production, was developed by Norman E. Borlaug. He is the father of green revolution in the world. Dr. Varghese Kurien, he started Amul in Gujarat. Anand, place name is Anand. Okay, so he is the father of white revolution in India. Father of green revolution in India, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Alexander von Humboldt, botanical geography. He studied botanical geography. Then Paul Ehrlich, first time he gave the treatment to a bacterial disease, that is a usually sexually transmitted disease, that is syphilis. Next, in plant breeding programs, the entire collection of plant or seeds having all diverse allele of all the gene given in a given crop is germplasm collection. Species of Saccharum originally grown in North India was Saccharum barbarum. Which part is most suitable for raising virus-free plant in micropropagation? That is meristem. Shoot apical meristem, having mainly that part axillary bud meristematic cells. Yeast Saccharomyces cerevisiae is used in the industrial production of ethanol, alcohol production. Tetracycline is antibiotic obtained from Streptomyces. Citric acid derived from Aspergillus niger. This is butanol or butyl alcohol, alcoholic fermentation. In cheese manufacture, the microorganisms are used for souring of milk and ripening only. So both 1 and 2. Famous Swiss cheese variety, you know, developed by Propionibacterium schermani. It has larger holes on its surface. What it has? Larger holes on its surface. Which bacterium help in the production of Swiss cheese? That is Propionibacterium schermani. Okay. Trichoderma polysporum, Aspergillus niger, citric acid, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is the yeast, can be used in bakery, can be used in alcoholic fermentation. Trichoderma polysporum, a bioactive molecule compound that is cyclosporin A. Okay, that is used as immunosuppressive drug. Statin, a bioactive molecule inhibiting the enzyme responsible for synthesis of cholesterol. Statins are derived from yeast, a fungus, Monascus purpureus. Okay, so this reduces the activity of enzyme HMG coenzyme reductase, HMG coenzyme A reductase enzyme. Beta hydroxy, beta methyl glutaryl coenzyme reductase, which is involved in cholesterol synthesis. Okay, so this activity of enzyme is blocked by statin, thereby blood cholesterol is lower. So these are used as blood cholesterol lowering agent. blood cholesterol lowering agents. Remember, beta hydroxy, beta methyl glutaryl coenzyme reductase. This enzymatic activity involved in cholesterol synthesis is reduced or blocked by statins. Ganga and Yamuna action plan is initiated by. So particularly, we have to protect the major rivers from mixing with sewage. Okay, sewage treatment plants have to be set up. Water should be clearly treated there. Then it can be released into water bodies. So it was initiated by Ministry of Environment and Forest to protect the holy rivers of North India. Roquefort cheese is produced with the help of a fungus, okay, a mold. That mold is Penicillium roqueforti. Okay, this cheese variety, green, yellow color mottling it has, surface it has. It is prepared usually from sheep's milk. Okay, world famous cheese variety. Roquefort cheese variety. Another one is the Camembert cheese variety. It is produced by Penicillium Camembert. Remember, Rhizopus nigricans. It is a source of enzymes such as maltase, amylase. Rhizopus nigricans, source of enzymes like maltase, amylase. Yeast is used in alcoholic fermentation, you know that. Which of the following statement is true? Okay. We know about BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. The amount of oxygen that would be consumed if all the organic matter were oxidized, broken down in by the bacteria in 1 liter of water. That is BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. The amount of oxygen consumed to break down the all organic matter present in 1 liter of water by bacteria. So here, if BOD value is more, water is highly polluted. If BOD value is less, water is less polluted. Remember, we will go with first option. Greater the BOD of wastewater, more is its polluting potential. Which of the following organic acid was produced by fermentation? Lactic acid. Okay, lactic acid fermentation. By Lactobacillus lactis. Citric acid from Aspergillus niger, all that you know. Primary sludge is used for after primary treatment. Primary sewage treatment, you will get primary sludge. Okay, it is used for making compost. Which of the following is not true about antibiotics? Not true. First antibiotic was discovered by Alexander Fleming, okay. The term antibiotic was coined by Salmon Waxman, correct. Some persons can be allergic to a particular antibiotic, correct. Each antibiotic is effective only against one particular kind of germ. The present day antibiotics are broad spectrum antibiotics. They are broad spectrum antibiotics, means they are effective against wide range of microbes. Not only effective against only one germ or microbe, but they can be effective against different microbes, bacteria, fungus, protozoans, etc. Biogas consists of mainly, you know, methane, 65% carbon dioxide and 30% hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen sulfide, these in small amount, around 5%. So we will go for what you call second option here. Which one of the following pairs is wrongly matched? Wrongly matched, they are asking. Yeast used in ethanol production, fine. Streptomycetes, okay, they are source of antibiotic, correct. One genera, that is Streptomyces, very famous. More than 70 antibiotics can be extracted from this genera. Methanogens, you know about Methanobacterium ruminatum, used in production of cobra gas, biogas, correct. Coliforms is incorrect match. Vinegar, coliforms, they are living in colon region of intestine. Okay, particularly E. coli. Which one of the following is a wrong matching of a microbe and its industrial product, while the remaining three are correct? Yeast, statin, okay, yeast, Monascus purpureus, correct. Acetobacter esti, acetic acid, correct. Then Aspergillus niger, used in citric acid production, correct. Here third is wrong. Clostridium butylicum, it is a source of butyric acid production. It produces butyric acid. Lactic acid is produced by Lactobacillus lactis. Next, the most abundant prokaryotes helpful to humans in making curd from milk and in production of antibiotics are the ones categorized as heterotrophic bacteria. Remember, cyanobacteria, blue-green algae, nostoc, anabina. Usually they are photosynthetic and nitrogen fixing. Archaebacteria, you have what you call methanogens, halophiles, thermoacidophiles. These are all archaebacteria. They are adapted to extreme conditions of the environment. Very extreme condition they can. Chemosynthetic autotrophs, sulfur bacteria, okay, iron bacteria, hydrogen bacteria, nitrifying bacteria, they are all chemosynthetic autotrophs. Means they synthesize organic food. Energy, what they will use, energy they use released from exothermic reaction. They don't use sunlight. If they use sunlight, photosynthetic autotrophs we can call. So what they use, the energy which is released from the exergonic reaction or exothermic reactions in the soil, that can be used. So that is also fine. So answer is here, yeah, heterotrophic bacteria. During sewage treatment, biogas are produced, which include, so what it include, that composition I have told already, methane 65%, hydrogen, sulfide, carbon dioxide. So this fourth one is right. Name the blank spaces A, B, C, and D from the table given below. Fungus, it is Trichoderma polysporum. Okay, it is a source of cyclosporin. I have given already. It is used as immunosuppressive drug. For whom? For organ transplanted patients. Immunosuppressive drug. It means, you know, the killer T lymphocytes, which are involved in rejecting the transplanted organ after successful transplantation. So this cyclosporin A suppress though the killer T lymphocytes which are rejecting the transplanted organ, their activity is minimized without disturbing the immune system. That's why they can be used as immunosuppressive drugs, particularly in organ transplantation. Then C, that is yeast. It is a fungus by name Monascus purpureus. It is a source of statin. It is used as blood cholesterol lowering agent. So we'll go with first option. Match the column 1 with column 2 and choose the right options. Statins. Statins, you know, blood cholesterol lowering agent. Ethanol. Yeast is your. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Dung is a raw material for biogas or gopher gas production. Bt cotton, insect resistant plant. Resistant to lepidopterans, coleopterans, diapterans. I mean the butterflies, caterpillars, all that. Okay. So here, this first option is right. Read the following statement having two blanks A and B. A, drug used for dash patient and is obtained from species of the organism dash. The correct option for two blanks is, okay, organ transplanted patients obtained from the species of Trichoderma, right? Microbes are used in, where we use microbes, secondary sewage treatment, where the sewage water BOD value is decreased mainly by the growth of flocks, right? Anaerobic sludge digester, here also microbes are there, where microbes act on the organic matter, finest organic matter, and produce biogas. Then production of bioactive molecules, statins. Okay, then cyclosporin A. Then another very important enzyme, bioactive molecule, streptokinase enzyme, which is used to dissolve the blood clot, clot buster. Okay, statin, Monascus purpureus, cyclosporin A, Trichoderma polysporum, streptokinase derived from Streptococcus species. So they are all derived from microbes, except primary treatment of sewage, except primary sewage treatment. So third option is right. So in the primary treatment of sewage, larger and smaller, this floating debris and small stones, pebbles, all these will be removed mainly by filtration, and one more process, sedimentation. So it is purely, this primary treatment is purely a physical process. It is not biological process, which do not make use of any microbes. Thereby, the larger and smaller sized particles, no, which are floating on the surface of the sewage, and even suspended impurities by sedimentation can be removed without the involvement of microbes. Remaining three, second, third, fourth, microbes are yours. The vitamins whose content increases following the conversion of milk into curd by lactic acid bacteria, you know that is vitamin B12. Wastewater treatment generates a large quantity of sludge, which can be treated in what you call anaerobic sludge digester. This is anaerobic sludge digester. The major portion of activated sludge is introduced into this anaerobic sludge digester, where complete in absence of oxygen, anaerobic microbes play a very important role, can produce biogas also. Match the column of bioactive substance and their role. Statin, lowering blood cholesterol. Okay, then cyclosporin A, immunosuppressive drug in organ transplanted patient. Streptokinase, removal of clot from blood vessels. Myocardial infraction, the patients who have suffered with myocardial infraction, to remove the blood clot, the streptokinase is used as clot buster. Okay, lipase, it is used in laundry, it is used in detergents. So particularly a grease or oil stain is there, that can be removed by lipase. So answer is here, fourth option. Okay, moving on to the next one now. The primary treatment of sewage or wastewater involves the removal of, so what it involves mainly, stable particle, okay, the floating debris in the form of paper, plastic, lightweight particles, okay, then suspended in the form of soil, grit, pebble. These are all removed by a physical process. It involves mainly filtration and it involves mainly sedimentation. These, remember. BOD of wastewater is estimated by measuring the amount of oxygen consumption. See, in the sewage water, organic matter is present. Okay, it is biodegradable organic matter in the form of human excreta, animal excreta, and other forms of waste. See, these aerobic bacteria and fungi, they act as a decomposers to break down this organic matter. To break down this organic matter, whatever the dissolved oxygen is there in the water, that is used up and they break down the organic matter. Okay, so they consume oxygen. So BOD of wastewater is estimated by measuring the amount of oxygen. If BOD value is high, it indicates water is polluted. That means it requires more and more oxygen for the breakdown of the organic matter. If BOD value is less, then oxygen consumed is very less, negligible. Then we can say less polluted water, or it can be drinking water, potable water, whatever it is. Which one of the following alcoholic drinks is produced without distillation? See, we usually carry out fermentation carried out by yeast, right? You have glycolysis, you have decarboxylation, you have reduction. These are the three steps of fermentation: glycolysis, decarboxylation, and reduction, carried out in fermentation chamber using yeast. Fermentation can continue up to 10 to 15% of alcohol concentration formed. Further, fermentation stops because of higher alcohol content formed. Okay, and that can be what you call harming this enzyme, zymase enzyme complex involved in alcoholic fermentation present in yeast. So in order to increase the alcohol percentage in the range of 40 to 55%, we need to carry out distillation, fractional distillation. Okay, so these are whiskey, rum, brandy, they're all produced because of distillation. Question is, which one of the following alcoholic drink is produced without distillation? That is mainly by fermentation. It is wine. Wine, beer, cider, they're all produced by fermentation, not by distillation. What would happen if oxygen availability to activated sludge flux is reduced? Suppose if oxygen supply is reduced, what happens? The flux which settle in the secondary settling tank as activated sludge. Okay, these will not grow properly. See here, the center flux will become anoxic, means oxygen supply will not be there. That would cause the death of bacteria, eventually breakage of flux. Flux, you know, the mass of bacteria. Associated with fungal filament to form mesh-like structure. Okay, so second one. Big holes in Swiss cheese are made by a bacterium, you know, Propionibacterium sharmani, that release a lot of carbon dioxide gas during metabolic activity, during fermentation. Okay, so what happens? Large amount of carbon dioxide is released, and that Swiss cheese has the large holes on its surface. Match the following list of microbes and their importance. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, commercial production of ethanol. Monascus purpureus, statins, okay, blood cholesterol lowering agents. Trichoderma polysporum, production of immunosuppressive drug. Propionibacterium sharmani, ripening of Swiss cheese. So answer is here, fourth option. Which of the following in sewage treatment removes suspended solids? I have told already, primary sewage treatment, it is a physical process. Okay, it involves sequential filtration and sedimentation. So it is primary treatment. Secondary treatment, mainly biological treatment, where microbes play very important role. Tertiary treatment, you can use ozone, you can use UV light. Okay, water can be treated to kill all pathogenic microbes. Chlorine gas also you can pass. Next, which of the following is correctly matched for the product produced by them? Methanobacterium, they have given lactic acid, it is wrong. Okay, Penicillium notatum acetic acid, they have given wrong. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, yeast ethanol, they have given, this is correct. Acetobacter acetate, antibiotics, from Streptomyces mainly. Acetobacter acetate, it produces acetic acid. Okay, Methanobacterium ruminatum, it can produce biogas. So third is correctly matched there. A bacterium dash produce commercial product which is used as a clot booster enzyme. It can be clot buster. It dissolves blood clot of the vessels. especially in heart patient, myocardial infarction. Okay, that is a streptokinase enzyme derived from Streptococcus bacteria. When it is genetically engineered, when this enzyme is genetically engineered, it is called TPA, used as a clot buster, used to dissolve blood clot. It is tissue plasminogen activator. Microbes are diverse, which includes bacteria, protozoans, fungi, ferns, they are plants, they are pteridophytes. Microbes are present in which habitat? Soil, air, water, hot thermal springs, so A, B, C, D, in all what we say. Usually, everywhere microbes are there, or cosmopolitan in distribution, like that we call. The distillation of the fermented broth is required for the formation of, as I mentioned, alcoholic beverage with higher percentage of alcohol, rum, brandy, and whiskey. So it is ACD. Beer is a fermentation product. Beer, wine, cider, all that. Besides curdling of milk, LAB also improve nutritional quality by increasing vitamin B12. LAB, when present in human stomach, check disease causing microbes. Second one. Okay, both assertion reason are true, but reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. The gas responsible for puffing of appearance of dough comes from fermentation. Okay, when you use wheat flour or maida flour mixed with water and you add yeast tablet, okay, due to fermentation, carbon dioxide is released. That's why that dough has a puffed up appearance. Bread will become, when you make bread from that, bread will become soft, spongy, puffy. The chemical substances produced by some microbes which can kill or retard the growth of other microbes, mainly antibiotics. The amount of oxygen required by the microbes in the decomposition of organic matter is called as, okay, so biochemical oxygen demand, BOD, what we call oxygen consumed to break down the organic matter in sewage water. Match the column 1 and column 2 with the given option. Fermenter, large vessels for growing microbes. Bread, baker's yeast. Aerobic microbes, okay, flocks, right? Then Ganga Action Plan, Ministry of Environment and Forest. So answer is fourth option. Sewage or municipal waste should not be directly passed into river streams and other water bodies because it contain human excreta and other organic waste, correct? It contain number of disease-causing microbes, correct? So both 1 and 2. Which of the following statements are false? Antibiotic word is misnomer. Anti, the Greek word which means against, life, against the life of pathogen, right? While in respect to human being, it is pro-life, okay, not against. Flocks are mass of bacteria with interwoven fungal filament, right? Component of biogas are carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, nitrogen sulfide traces. Okay, they are not given methane here. Methane abundant, mainly 65%, right? So here C is incorrect. Only C is incorrect, right? So I will stop here. So tomorrow we will have discussion on biotechnology, what you call principle and process, very important topic. So tomorrow we'll discuss that. Right, okay.